Good morning, guys. I am Mrs. Aimee Antalawe. So I will be your teacher in building and enhancing new literacies across the curriculum. So actually, I have already uploaded our course syllabus. You can check that in our Facebook page that we have created. And also, I think I sent this also to our group chat. Okay, so check your messages. Also, I uploaded the first module. You may check the copies under. So today we are going to discuss module number 1, and it's all about the introduction to 21st century literacy. So I prepared this during our long break. Okay, so you ready? But before that, I want to show you our course guide. Let me just pull it up here. So week 1, that's supposed to be Monday yesterday and up to September 11. So actually, we don't have a face-to-face orientation meeting. So I prepared this video to discuss our mission, vision, goals, and objectives. And then for the second week, we're supposed to discuss this first module, but I think we're good with the VMGO, the vision, mission, goals, and objectives, because you've been studying those when you were in the first year and then second year, and now your third year, you're almost there. Congratulations, guys, in advance. Okay, so without much any ado, may we go back to our presentation now here. Let me just pull this up from current slide. Okay, so introduction. With the objectives of increasing awareness among readers, can you see it all there, who might be unaware of the existing perspective on literacy, a chance for teachers to think and reflect on their own literacies, an attempt to impart the new 21st literacies to their students. This module explore several definitions of literacy and what being literate means in the multiplicity of contexts in the 21st century. Okay, so this is just an overview. Now, our learning outcome, we are expected to define what is conventional literacies. And number 2, we have to develop a clear and practical understanding of the expanded views of literacy in the 21st century. Learning content. So you expect that this module will contain readings, selections, and discussion questions, and sets of activities that students can work on individually or by group. So we have 3 topics. Topic number 1, we have the traditional or conventional literacy. Topic number 2, expanded views on literacy. Topic number 3, literacy in the 21st century. Alright, so this we'll discuss topic number 1. This is traditional or conventional literacy. Okay, so in exploring and discussing the new literacies of the 21st century, a thorough perspective of literacy and its past meaning will give us a solid foundation and why possessing them is now required for both teachers and students in all levels of education. According to literacy is defined by dictionaries as the state of being able to read and write. So that was the first definition of literacy. If you know how to read, if you know how to write, that's actually literacy, right? Okay, now in the 15th century, the word literacy stems from the word literate, and it was derived from the Latin word literatus, meaning a person marked with letters that is distinguished or identified by letters and is carried with the idea that such person was cultured and educated. Okay, so if a person knows how to read and write, or they are identified by letters, they are literate, they are cultured, they are educated, and they belong to the elite group. All subjects of the time, such as grammar, logic, arithmetic, geometry, and others, were written texts that had to be studied. The ability to write and read was therefore of prime importance. leading to the strong association of being literate with the ability to read and write. Okay, there are three subcategories of literacy. According to Miller, this was taken from his book, 1973, the conventional concepts of literacy is divided into three subcategories. So number one, as you can see in there, it's basic literacy. It is the ability to correspond visual shapes to spoken sounds in order to decode written materials and translate them into oral language. By the way, before I proceed with the discussion, this is one of my reference book that I use, and most of the topics are taken from the internet because, as you know, this is a new subject, so you expect we don't have much material. So it's good we have this as our references. Okay, one of our references. So it's good. All of the topics that I am discussing, it's also taken here and from other sources. Now, we go back to basic literacy. If you simply put all of these, it is the ability to recognize letters and words. So this would be akin to recognizing that the sequence of letters, basa, B-A-S-A, forms the word basa in Filipino, even without understanding what it means. So when you hear the word basa, you have to read. That is basic literacy. That's why we have elementary levels where they are learning how to read and write. Yes? Agree with me? Of course. Okay, now we proceed to number two. This is comprehension literacy. So there's actually a level, right? When you know that you are in college, you are done with the elementary where you learn the basic knowledge that and skills that you need. High school, now our comprehension are increasing, and then the college, that's the time that you reach your highest level so far, although we know that we still have master's and doctor's degree, I should say. Now we go back to comprehension literacy. It is the ability to understand the meaning of what is being read. They capitalize on the example above. This would be like knowing that basa can either to read or to be wet. Ano kayang ibig sabihin yan? What does it mean? Anyone? Oh, okay, I know you can't answer me. So, anyway, when you say basa, that is in Filipino, it means to read or to be wet. Okay, then next number three, we have the functional and practical literacy. It is defined as the ability to read, such as decode and comprehend written materials needed them to perform everyday vocational tasks. This is the equivalent of reading the text, ang bata ay nagbabasa. And being able to understand that basa here refers to reading and not to being wet. Now, based on this conventional view of literacy, we notice two things for reading to exist. Number one, please take note, a text. A text that consists of symbols and grammar to be read. Number two, a meaning or message being communicated by the text for the reader to extract. Without the text, there would be nothing to read. Without meaning, the text is reduced to a series of incomprehensible doodles. So if you don't understand what you're reading, it's just some doodling, right? You can understand. Okay, as noted by Miller, the act of reading implies the level of understanding. Simply knowing how to say a word or a series of words is not the same as being able to understand what it means. Without understanding of the meaning of the words, reading has not taken place. All right, so based on this, Scletti 2001 defines the concept of functional literacy as the state of being able to read but not well enough to manage daily living and employment tasks that require reading skills beyond a basic level. Okay. let's proceed to topic number two. We have the expanded views of literacy. If you have questions on topic number one, I will post this later on our Facebook page. You might type or post your comment, your question in the comment box so I can answer you later on, all right? Now, let's proceed to topic number two, the expanded views of literacy. Okay, we're almost there. Roberts, 1995, notes that in the past 50 years, hundreds of definitions of literacy have been advanced by scholars, adult literacy workers, and program planners, with even the United Nations Educational, Scientific, and Cultural Organization, or the UNESCO 2006, acknowledging that literacy as a concept has proven to be complex and dynamic, it being continually defined and interpreted in multiple ways. So what are those ways? Let's see, coming from the UNESCO 2004, formally defined literacy as the ability to identify, take note, understand, number two, interpret, that's number three, create, that's number four, communicate, number five, and compute, number six. So please take note of that according to UNESCO 2004. Okay, literacy involves a continuum of learning in enabling individuals to achieve their goals, to develop their knowledge and potential, and to participate fully in their community and wider society. According to CanTheWire 2018, succinctly posts it that literacy is a form of knowledge, competence, and skills in a particular field of area, being supported by UNESCO 2006, Barton 2007, and McCandawire, Simuya Mudenda, and Chilo 2017, which acknowledge that as we have just pointed out, modern views appear to equate literacy with knowledge. Okay, we're almost there. Topic number three, literacies in the 21st century. And I believe you're all in here. So we're glad we reached this year. We reached this point in our lives and the 21st century. Throughout history, humans have communicated on levels apart from the spoken and written. For example, visually using the long-distance communication systems of smoke signals used by the ancient Chinese, the ancient Greeks, and the indigenous people of the Northern America. Greenway, 1884, in the Victorian era, there was such a thing as the language of flowers. So even if we have flowers, they have language on it. For example, they use the color and arrangement of bouquet of flowers were used to communicate what? Messages that could not otherwise be spoken aloud in Victorian society. So if you have a purple roses, what does it mean? What does it imply? What's the message that you can read between the lines? A purple roses, it means sorrow. White lilies, resurrection. Pale yellow tulips and rosemary, that is in memory or in remembrance. A bouquet of oak leaves representing the strength, and so forth and so on. And even here in the Philippines, right? We do believe that if they are using black clothes, it represents what? Sorrow. Yeah. So altogether, this communicates a message of sympathy, usually over the death of a loved one. Successfully interpreting this visual language required a kind of visual literacy to understand the message being presented and to manage the information encoded therein. Skills we are coming into use again in the 21st century literacies. The difference is that now we are not analyzing smoke signals or bouquets, but rather sounds, texts, images from 100 different sources at nearly non-stop rate, to the point where accuracy, validity, and reliability of the messages we interpret from the basis for some very important personal and collective decision making. Okay, I think we're already done with this. Okay, Now, we have here three things have been critical in the rise of the new literacies. Number one, we have the increased reach. We are communicating with more people from more diverse cultures across vaster distance than ever before. Number two, increased means of communication. We are communicating in more ways and a faster speeds than even before. Number three, increased breadth of content. We are communicating about more things than ever before. Now, this is an overview of what you expect for the whole course. We have here a globalization and multicultural literacy. If you can pull out your course syllabus, you can find the overall or the intense discussion of this on module number 2. That's globalization in here. Module number 2, okay? So, an overview for this, it discusses how our increasing ability to communicate with almost anyone, anywhere, in real time requires new skills and attitudes in interacting with people with cultures, perspective, worldviews, priorities different from our own. That's why we call it multicultural globalization. Okay, we are not the only one existing here. We have other nations also, and they have different cultures, different from us. Okay, so you have to be flexible. The second one, this is found on chapter 3 or module number 3. This is social and financial literacies. In here, we're going to explore the needs for the ability to navigate our own social networks or both the online and offline variety of leverage resources which we ourselves might not possess. And next, the media and cyber digital literacy, that's found on chapter 5. I think I jumped. We have chapter 4 later on, we will discuss. Okay, that explore the emerging need to locate, verify, and ultimately manage online information, especially in an age where information and the ability to communicate it with others and use it to address what? Real-world problems easily spell the difference between both personal and career success and failures. I think you are into this. We are using this actually, the media and cyber, the digital literacies. As you can see now, we're using internet, we're using laptop, we're using phones, we're using YouTube, Facebook. Okay, so we're actually into it now. So it's really a nice topic to discuss. Next, we have the eco-literacy and artistic and creative literacy. That's explore the emerging demands for knowing how to effectively and sustainably manage the natural resources that are increased. Industrialization and demands for productivity are rapidly eating up. So from the word eco, eco, artistic, creativity. What comes to your mind? Artistic, creative. Okay, so think of it. Now, this is the most critical, of course, from the word itself, critical literacy. That addresses the increasing need to discern the underlying messages behind the new texts of the 21st century. Particularly in an ever-increasingly multicultural society where ideas, cultures, and ideologies view with one another for power and dominance in the minds of the masses. So I think we're done. So here's the summary. As you can see, I have encoded it there so you have a ready reference. Okay. Now, for teaching and learning activities, this will be recorded. You have to answer these and give relevant examples to support your answer. You may write your answers in a clean piece of yellow paper, or you might want to encode that and then send your answers to my Gmail account, which is italawe.ph@gmail.com. Please do not forget to write your name, your course year and section, and the module number. Okay, and the module title, I should say. So without that, I will be lost. So do not forget to indicate those very important subject that I told a while ago. Okay, so I think I have 5 questions for the teaching and learning activities. This will be your quiz number 1. So you answered that. That will be your quiz. This will be submitted next week. Next week, Monday. Okay, what's the day on next week, Monday? On the 14th of September, 2020. And then, these are the materials that I used to compile the modules. Okay, you just check that on our... Oh, by the way, this is quiz number one. We got two only questions. So the first five questions, maybe go back here. The first five questions that we have here that will serve as your activities or your performance tasks or essay. Okay? Just like classwork in mathematics. But this one is in essay form. We have to answer five questions. Brief only. Not too much, please. Just 1 to 2 pages of paper would be good. Okay, but for your quiz, I got two questions. Number one, compare and contrast the traditional concept of literacy to the modern view of literacy. So, what's good in online is that you can browse, you can check the internet, but if you copy, I need you to write also where the source and then you have to give your own view or your perception. Do not just copy and give that to me as your answer. Please, you have to base your answer and then give your own perception. You give your own idea. You can give relevant examples to support your answer. So that is how to make a good essay. And then number two, describe the changes in the 21st century that had led to the rise of the new literacies. Okay, so if you don't have much questions, I think we're good. And I'll be hearing from you next week. Okay, thank you so much for listening. Okay, bye-bye.